The Riverside Show, sponsored by Fix from C.R. Smith.
Hello and welcome to the Riverside Show. It's Friday night and we're shaking things up here on STV Glasgow. The lovely Amy Irons from the STV Glasgow news team's here. First time presenting
First
the show.
First time, Jerry. I'm so excited. It's lovely to be on this side of the sofa instead of this one.
Thank you.
Now, we've got loads coming up on the show tonight and we'll explain what David got up to today as he has our first My Glasgow series. And Glaswegian comic book genius Mark Miller will be live on the sofa.
Pretty good stuff. But before all of that, it's Friday night and you know by now the Riverside Show is the home of live music. So let's get some on air right now.
Now, Jerry, we do need to apologise in advance,
do
first
we?
Of all, yes, because our act is actually our director Laura's favourite band
oh
ever.
My.
So please bear with us if the camera goes a bit crazy, a bit erratic, because it's not easy for her to direct and sing and dance in the gallery.
She's going to go mental in her ears, isn't she, during
yes,
this performance?
All right. Anyway, without further ado, with We Can Run, this is Skerryvore.
Woo!
off. You're great.
That was brilliant. I really enjoyed that.
Good way to kick off Friday night, and we'll have more live music from Skerryvore throughout the show. We have got a great Friday night show lined up for you. Here's what's coming up before 8:30 tonight.
We love Glasgow, you love Glasgow, so let's celebrate our city. Tonight, David's not on the sofa as he launches our My Glasgow series. Find out where Farrell hangs out, we meet his mammy, and she tells us about wee David growing up in Glasgow. Special effects and light shows are illuminating Glasgow's Botanic Gardens this weekend, but if you can't make it along, or you want to stay in and cootie up on the sofa, then that's okay too, as last night we got a preview of Electric Gardens. It's Burns Night this weekend, so Colin is perfecting his cooking skills by learning to make the perfect haggis, neeps and tatties. But not to be outdone, we've got Chef Guy Cowan in the Riverside Show kitchen to teach me and Amy how to make the perfect national dish for under a tenner.
So Colin got a cooking lesson earlier, and that'll come in handy as he's actually at the world's biggest Burns Supper held right here in Glasgow. Let's cross over to him live now. Tell us more, Colin.
Well, thanks, Amy, and yes, as you can see, I put on my finest Burns-esque shirt for the official largest Burns Supper in the world being held right here in Glasgow. I'm at the Thistle Hotel for the official Lords Provost Civic Reception. Paul Cooney's just got proceedings underway, and fingers crossed we'll have a chat with the Lord Provost herself later in the show. But I'm looking forward to trying some haggis later.
He scrubs all, Paul, right? Look at him.
I know.
Has he got a kilt on, though?
Oh, he didn't show us. Colin, what to see that next time.
We'll have to find... Wait, you'll have to wait and find that out if you want to, anyway. Now, you may have noticed David and Jennifer aren't here. Jen's having a long weekend with her wee sister down the Lake District, all right for some. And David has been on a special assignment.
Tonight on the Riverside Show, we're launching our My Glasgow series, where we ask some well-known faces to take us around the city to their favourite places and tell us what Glasgow means to them. So, where better to start, you know, than with our very own presenter, David Farrell.
So today, the Riverside Show producers let me off the leash. They've let me out of the studio, and I'm showing you My Glasgow. So I thought I'd take you back to where it all began for me and share with you some of my fondest memories. It's a lovely day for a walk around the park. I'm here at Rook and Glen Park. And I always used to come here when I was a wee boy. My mum, dad, grand, grandpa, everyone took me here. Right now, when I look out here, I think I am actually the only person standing in this park on a miserable day. So right now I feel lonely and cold, but lots of happy memories with Rook and Glen Park and the summer months, and even actually coming down here in the winter when we used to get the cold winters and the heavy snow. It used to be brilliant. The pond used to be iced over. But it's one of those parks that just reminds you of your family and good times and running about with the dogs. And mum and dad had two dogs as well, two wee lass Apsos. Now we've got Dollar, who's the American Beagle. The memory that I always have from this park is actually rowing the boats in summer out there, getting to that little island in the middle. And I always was convinced that people lived on it, that wee island over there. And just up behind the pond's a little kind of, it's an open space with a load of boulders and rocks. Used to play there as well when I was a kid. So lots of good memories down here at Rook and Glen Park. And Dollar loves it as well, don't you, Dollar? Dollar, do you like the park? He likes the park. He's just wanting to go for a wander now and go for a nosy. When I come home, we always have dinner here, don't we?
That's your seat.
Somehow I've been put to that side of this. Yeah. I was used to be stuck at this side of the table. For some reason, I'm getting further out the window, out the door. And that's my dad's side of the table as well. And my mum's very kindly got some pictures to hand, because you've been looking through pictures, because you gave me some pictures the other day. Yeah. And I don't really know if I want to show anyone these pictures. That was when I went and bought a pair of trainers. Oh, remember, yes, I started running.
One of the outlets.
Every day, yes. Up and down the street, because I'd always carried quite a bit of weight up to that point, didn't I?
That's true, you're trying to work it off, yeah.
And talking of carrying the weight, this photo, oh no. What age must I have been in that picture then?
Around your teens.
Teens in age and in weight, to those things.
You'd be about,
14
maybe?
And 14 stone. That's unbelievable.
He was just quite a family boy. You know, he was quite a quiet, reserved child. That has changed somewhat, but however.
Hope you enjoyed the peace and quiet while you had it.
Yes, I did. Mm.
So we're now in Glentine Drive in Pollock, and the reason I brought you here is because this is where I spent quite a lot of my younger years. My mum and dad travelled quite a lot with business, so I grew up with my gran and grandpa off and on for quite some time, and Glentine Drive in Pollock is where that happened. And it's just something strange to look at, to see this street completely different from the memories that are with me. And those memories that I've got are running about these streets with other kids in the family. And at the back of the tenements would have been the middens, the bins. You stick your bins out. And the game that I used to play was just jumping the middens. So you jump from one side to the other, because it was like a concrete block with a kind of concrete canopy over them. You stick your plastic bins under there, and that was you. But you could jump across or run and hide and seek in the middens. What I remember as the old Pollock Centre, it's a pretty well-known Glasgow shopping centre now, but I always used to come here with my gran and grandpa, and just over there was where the from here used to bring me down after school. We'd go to the van, get the fish, and then another day we'd go to the chippy, the Old Witch Chippy, just at the end of the Pollock Centre, the old Pollock Centre before it was knocked down for this new shopping centre. But some great memories here with my gran going for a wee roll and chips.
We learnt loads about David there.
I
knew he liked to roll in chips.
What about those pictures of him in the Lilo, thinking he was all cool, eh?
Ever so slightly.
Now, this weekend sees the premiere of the latest Hollywood blockbuster comic book to hit our movie screens, with an all-star cast including Colin Firth, Samuel L. Jackson, Michael Caine and Mark Hamill, to name a few. That's one move over already, Jerry. Sounds great.
It sounds absolutely brilliant. Kingsman: The Secret Service is based on the comic written by one of Glasgow's most successful exports to Hollywood, comic book writer, and I think it's fair to say genius, Mark Miller. I have to say that because he's here, who created Wanted, Kick-Ass and numerous Marvel comics and movies. And we're delighted to say hello. Welcome to the Riverside Show.
I love this genius thing. I'm going to start using this myself.
Oh, you could use that more often, yeah. So it's the world premiere of Kingsman right here in Glasgow.
Not technically world, it's the Scottish premiere. London got in there first. We had the London premiere last week.
And how did that go?
It was a fantastic night. I mean, Take That were performing live for us. We were literally standing on a balcony. We Take That over Leicester Square. Mm-hmm. Brilliant night. We were loving it, you know, and then somehow picked up a tummy bug, you know. So, like, things have a way of balance now. We did the best night ever, but I shook too many hands. Somebody didn't wash their hands after going to the toilet. I had a tummy bug for a week.
See,
you know?
I do non-contact high fives. That's the way forward.
Oh, no, you guys have got this now.
Yeah, I've got this down, yeah.
This is the longest I've gone without throwing up, actually. This is amazing.
Well, let's
keep it that way.
Let's
keep it that way,
tonight, yeah.
So, you say the Scottish Premier is obviously on Sunday.
Yes.
You know, but tell us a bit about what the proceeds of that are going to. I believe it's your old school,
yes,
is that right?
Yes, it's a thing. Years ago, actually, my old primary, a lot of my cousins and nephews and nieces and things go to my old primary school. And just whenever the cash squeeze happened, around about 2008, a lot of schools and local authorities didn't get the cash they used to have, and the school trips stopped. And I was horrified because, you know, the school can't help it. Mm-hmm. You know, there was just no cash around. And I thought it'd be quite nice to maybe raise a wee bit of cash. So every time I have a premiere, we give all the proceeds from the opening night to our old school. And we do other things as well, you know, that we can auction off characters and things whenever I have a new book out or something. And we've raised quite a wee bit of dough, you know, so we've been able to send all the children on school trips every year and, you know, revitalise the school library and stuff like
that. So what's the name of the school and where is it, sorry?
St. Bartholomew's School in Coatbridge. That's where I went. And they taught me how to read and write. Mm-hmm. And for a writer, that's quite a big thing. So I feel I owe them big time.
Yes. Yeah. Now, you're still based in the west of Scotland, is that right?
Yeah.
So, but you could easily move to LA or Hollywood if you want to. Why don't you?
Well, do you know, it's funny, everybody always says that to me. Like, I work in Los Angeles and not, you know, my publishing side of things is in New York and has been for 20 years. Mm-hmm. And the film sides I've had for about 8 years in Los Angeles. But but I love living here. And people always say, you know, like, why don't you move to LA? But it's kind of like, that's kind of the office, you know. Like, I like coming home. It's my actual pals are here. They're like my colleagues, you know. And you wouldn't want to hang about with your colleagues all the time, you know. So,
well, some of them are all right. I don't mind hanging out with some of you. Yeah, they're all right.
But I kind of love it here, you know. And it's like, you know, these are the guys I hang about with are people I've hung about with since primary school or high school and things, you know. Whereas, you know, work relationships, it's a wee bit more transient and everything. And I think the minute you kind of forget where you came from is the minute you've gone mad, isn't it? You know. So I just commute, and it's tiring. I mean, it's knackering. I'm exhausted. But you know, you can catch a flight back from New York and be home in 5.5 hours, you know, so, like, it's been fine. I've done it for 20 years now.
Gosh, that is a lot of commuting, Mark, and you've got a family and everything as well that you have to fit into that too. Yeah. It must be quite difficult.
I just spend less time with the children. You know,
so. Bye, kids.
Yeah. No, it's actually, it works out pretty well because I work from home a lot of the time. The kids see me all the time, so when I get up in the morning, you know, the kids are there before they go off to nursery and everything, so it's actually fine.
So tell us how you actually got into comic book writing in the start. How did you become a fan of it all?
Well, just as a kid, I was really into it. Like, growing up in the west of Scotland, I used to watch from STV, actually, Glenn Michaels' Cartoon Cavalcade.
You
know, that was my entry point into it. So for me, I felt Glenn knew these guys, like Bugs Bunny, Batman, all this kind of thing, you know? Yep. So, like, you know, that I got a real passion for it as a kid and never grew out of it. So, you know, instead of having a real job, I just thought, wouldn't it be fun to do this stuff? So I did comics, and then through comics went into Hollywood, and I still do comics half the time, maybe, and then I produce those things as movies whenever we turn them into a big picture.
And they have been incredibly successful. Kick-Ass was fantastic.
Oh, thanks.
Tell us a bit about Kingsman. What's all that about?
The setup of this is quite interesting. The director of Kick-Ass has directed this movie as well.
Is
and
that
it came
Matthew
Vaughn? Yeah. He and I were in the pub whenever Kick-Ass was being filmed, and there was a shop being set up, and we went to the pub, and we're talking about how sort of rubbish James Bond is now, and how we hate Jason Bourne and all that kind of stuff. You know, like, I mean, they're really dull spy films. I like those big sort of Monday, you know, Bank Holiday Monday kind of spy movies. Something that's a bit of a laugh. He makes a joke after he kills a guy, gets off with somebody exotic and everything, you know. And
just a regular Wednesday for you, right?
And we're saying we kind of miss that. Like, when I was a wee boy, you wanted to be a spy when you grew up. Whereas you don't want to be Jason Bourne. It looks miserable, doesn't it? And Bond always has a wee cry after he's killed somebody now and everything, you know. So we thought, let's do a big fun sort of bank holiday movie again. And we applied the same sort of Kick-Ass sensibility to it. So it's horrendously violent, full of swearing. I do apologise to everyone, you know. But we just had a great time doing it. We got Colin Firth to play this sort of James Bond style character in it, this sort of slightly older super spy, a gentleman super spy. And the plot of it is him training up a young Ned to be a gentleman super spy. So it's kind of like My Fair Lady for boys, where it's a wee Ned with a baseball cap and all this kind of
love
thing.
Love the use of the word Ned as well, by the way, for those of us who know what that means.
And
very
he's
quickly
to
as well, you obviously you live here, you studied here. What's the comic book scene like in Glasgow?
Exciting. Yep. I think Scotland overall, I mean, Scotland's got a fantastic history with comics with Oor Willy, and even predating that, I think the first comic ever invented in the world was in Scotland, so we carry on that tradition. And can I just actually say, the premiere on Sunday night, I forgot to mention this, but it's really important, we have tickets available. You can show up probably on the night as well, even, you know, so, and every single penny, there's no cut being taken by the cinema or anything, every penny has been donated to the school. So don't go any other night, come Sunday night to the Scottish premiere. I'm going to host it, and literally nothing's going to hot fat cats in Hollywood or anything. It's literally all going to St. Bartholomew's Primary in Cupbridge.
Well, you've won us over.
Oh,
we'll be there.
Where do we have to go?
Cineworld in Renfrew Street.
Cineworld. We'll be there.
Yep. You can buy a ticket online, but you could show up in the door too.
Great stuff. We'll see you there. Thanks very much for popping in. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Mark.
All the best. Now, we'll be having a look at what's got Glasgow talking in 2 minutes' time, but if you can't make it along to Kingsman Premiere, hopefully you will, but if you need some inspiration of what else you can get up to this weekend, you're in luck. Here's our very own Rachel Fulton with her Glasgow What's On guide.
Hello, it's finally time for your weekend What's On, where we've picked some great going out ideas for those of you who are out and about in town, but we still have some good TV if some of you are staying in. First up, this is a very special event close to all of us here on the Riverside Show. One, because we absolutely love electronic Celtic fusion bands from the Isle of Skye, obviously. And two, because our technical operator, Innes, happens to be a musician in this particular electronic Celtic fusion band from the Isle of Skye. Yes, Nightworks are at the Oranmore, and it's tonight. And next up, This Is Not a Burns Night is on this weekend, a fundraiser for Govan Hill Baths Community Trust, including music, drama, poetry and rap with Becky Wallace, Loki, Lenka Montenegro, Kat Hepburn and the Govan Hill Theatre Group. It's hosted by Jim Monaghan and you only pay what you think it's worth, so be generous about it. That's at the Govan Hill Baths from 7:30 tonight. And the Electric Gardens light up the Botanics in a way you've never seen them before this week, giving a beautiful visual display that'll give the Christmas season a twinkly run for its money. Even if you're not a West Ender, it's worth a trip to the Botanics this weekend with your kiddies to see the place illuminate. And there's a wonderful event at McSorley's with our pals, the Daddy Naggins, headlined by Daniel Mead and the Flying Mules. It's free entry, runs from 8 p.m. on Sunday night, and with a lineup like that, you'd be a fool not to at least drop in for a dram or a fruit cordial before hitting the town. And if none of that floats your boat, here's what's on the TV tonight. Coming up on STV Glasgow, we've got the STV Glasgow News at 8:30, followed by Days of Honour at 9, And it's Peter and Ruffy's football show at 10:30. Followed by more love from us in a repeat of the Riverside show at 11:30. All that still to come on STV Glasgow.
Loads going on in here in the city, but it's time to take a look at some of the local stories that's got Glasgow talking. We're joined by Gary Fanning from the Wishaw Press and Joe McGuire from Glasgow Now. And Gary, you've got our first story, and it's health-related and something to do with Glasgow Uni.
Yeah, it's been an outbreak of mumps at Glasgow University, where 10 students have caught the infection. And it comes after NHS Lanarkshire, which the Wishaw Press's catchment area got a press release in this week saying that up to 30 people had got mumps. So that was a tenfold increase. So there is a bit of an outbreak in Glasgow, Lanarkshire and Edinburgh at the moment.
Now, how serious, isn't it?
Excuse my ignorance, because I actually don't know much about it. So how serious actually are mumps?
Well, it can be very serious, Gerry, particularly if people have underlying conditions or if you're pregnant, etc. You know, but it's really a mild infection, you know. But the key is if you need treated, you should go and see a doctor straight away.
Now, is this outbreak being linked to the fact that some people haven't had the MMR vaccine?
That's a possibility, Amy. You know, if anyone doesn't have the two doses of the vaccine, they should go and get it right away, just in case it's spread by coughing, sneezing, etc. But there is 90% of people who have had the MMR vaccine should be okay, but there is that risk of 10% where it could be passed on.
Now, I'm a bit germ-phobic, actually, so I've always got these, like, anti-vax stuff. But what are the symptoms? What should I be worried about, Joe?
Well, I mean, the main thing that most people recognise, I've got the mumps. It would be the so-called hamster face, you know, the swollen glands.
Oh, I don't have that anyway, so...
But before you develop that, you might have sore joints and headaches. So, you know, these are things to keep an eye out for. And if so, go see your doctor.
Definitely. I mean, it's pretty worrying. It's something you don't think is going to happen. But yet, I take it, have Glasgow Uni said anything about trying to get it under control what students can do if they're concerned?
Yeah, so certainly, like, Glasgow Uni is basically saying, because there is this increased risk, don't hesitate, talk to your GP. And what the NHS are saying, they're going a step further, as you'd imagine. They're saying if you're born between 1980 and 1990, there's a good chance that you haven't received all the two stages of the MMR vaccine. So go along, make sure you're immunised, and that's the best thing to do.
Definitely. I'm going along. I was born then. Oh, no.
Yeah. I was 91, so I'm just after that.
How young is she?
Touch me.
Oh, my goodness, how young are you?
I know, you're the young one.
Aye.
On the show.
Right.
Now, Joe, fingers crossed, you know, we'll all be fine here, but you've got our next story, which I believe is from the Evening Times. Is that a bit more of a positive story?
It is. It's a very positive story. This is the story that the Commonwealth Games, which we all know it was a beautiful celebration of sport and culture in Glasgow, but it's also had some really great business benefits as well, with city businesses benefiting to the tune of £200 million.
£200 million.
So where did these figures actually come from? Because we see these figures all over the place.
Yeah.
Who's made up this amount of money?
Well, this information has been gathered from the Glasgow Business Portal. That was a website that was set up. So if you were a business, you wanted to bid to do something in games, you went through that. And there's, you know, they had some pretty strict regulations in terms of social benefit. If you wanted to bid, you had to take on long-term unemployed people or graduates. So that's where the information's coming from. To give you a few stats, so there was £700 million worth of games-related contracts. Of that, city firms won £423 million, while Scottish firms won £510 million. So it's big money.
That is a lot of money, isn't
yeah.
it?
Mm-hmm.
And obviously we hear a lot about the word legacy and stuff, but what about regeneration and parts of the city? How's that been?
I mean, I think all you need to do is look out that window and you see the hydro, and that's mm-hmm. obviously part of the regeneration. You go into the East End, you look at Parkhead, you look at the Emirates and the Athletes' Village, and these are tangible benefits that you can see in touch of Glasgow 2014. On top of that, a survey has just been released, as this is where the six-month mark from the Games, mm-hmm. Which is saying that 84% of Scots are more motivated to take part in physical activity. So there you've got that kind of health benefit as well. So I think there's a real legacy there, yeah.
And you and I are one of those, actually.
Yes,
you've been blogging and I've been working out.
I'm doing a boot camp thing at the Shed Nightclub. It's worth checking out. And I did that as a direct result of, I looked at these guys and how fit they were, and I was amazed at the feats of athleticism. I thought, I want to get a bit of that.
Definitely.
So. Me too.
A lot of people did, though, didn't they? I mean, when it's in your own city and you are seeing the best athletes in the world coming here, you think, I want to be like them, whether it's I'm going to cycle to my work or do whatever. But a lot of people, as you say, it's not just the money thing.
No.
It is the health legacy that has been left behind. And
very quickly,
really
it helped
good.
Graduates as well, wasn't there?
That's right, yeah. There's about 800 graduates have found jobs thanks to the graduate scheme. You know, £10 million was pumped into that. 3,000 youngsters across the country, the city has benefited from it, either in training, jobs or an apprenticeship.
Brilliant stuff. Can't believe it was 6 months ago, but we're still reaping the benefits. Guys, thanks very much indeed for joining us tonight on Friday night. Alrighty, we're going to take a quick break now, but do stay with us here on the Riverside Show, because coming up, we're going to cook. Amy, it's the first time you're going to experience tea for a tenner.
Oh, I'm so...
minutes. Bye-bye.
The Riverside Show, sponsored by Fix from C.R. Smith.
Become a recruitment genius and recruit the best staff available for just £199 with recruitmentgenius.com.
Teaser rate credit cards. It's you versus your bank. Either you remember when they told you the introductory rate would end, or you forget. You get caught out when the interest rate rockets up and end up paying a whole lot more. You both want to win, but only one of you can. Is this really the sort of relationship you want? It's why at Royal Bank of Scotland we've said goodbye to teaser rate credit cards and hello to credit cards that won't try to catch you out. Goodbye, unfair banking. Hello, Royal Bank of Scotland.
For the first time ever, Persil has combined a new boosted liquid with built-in stain removers. Persil Dual Action Capsules penetrate and attack stains, giving you an unbeatable clean. Try new Persil Dual Action Capsules in your wash today. Always keep away from children.
What did I gain with age?
Confidence.
Strength.
Friends that matter.
The look that defines me.
You gain so much with age. Why should your hair lose? Regardless of how old you are, your hair matures from root to tip. Dove Youthful Vitality helps replenish the nutrients hair loses, leaving hair soft, shiny, and looking fuller. Dove Youthful Vitality by Dove Advanced Hair Series.
Experience a Canadian journey. Step aboard, watch the world float by. Relax in style, under our beautiful skies. Enjoy unrivaled views, guaranteed to enthrall. Cruise, train, or car. In Canada, you can do it all. Enjoy relaxing, tailor-made holidays across Canada by train, coach, car, or cruise ship. You can do it all with CanadianAffair.com. 20th anniversary sale now on.
I know what you're thinking. He looks like a bit of a geek. But when you've invented the cure for comparison blindness, you can look as geeky as you want. Using independent data from DeFacto, Go Compare lets you easily see the difference between home or car policies. Go compare that.
The Riverside Show, sponsored by Fix from C.R. Smith.
Welcome back to the Riverside Show, where we're celebrating Burns a couple of days early here with a Burns-themed tea for a tenner. And we've no... I can't believe I'm going to say this, but I'm going to say... Now, we know that a man's a man for all that, but this man is even more than all that, apparently. We've got Guy Cowan from Guy's Kitchen with us. Had to do it. Sorry, but a Burns there. I'm guessing haggis.
Haggis and clapshot.
And what?
Clapshot.
Tell us more.
Potatoes... Turnip, mashed together, butter, cream, spring onions, black pepper.
Great stuff, that this all looks great. Are you a haggis, neeps and tatties fan?
Definitely. Oh, I love it. It's right up there on my favourite food list.
And
sounds
a wee whisky gravy.
Even better, Guy, even better.
So we've got loads of ingredients here. Do you want to talk us through it, first of all?
OK. Well, We've got a drop of whiskey. We've got
drop whiskey.
These red potatoes, rooster potatoes, which are great for mash.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And to them, we're going to add some butter and cream.
That's a lot of butter and a lot of cream.
Well, it's
once a year. That's right.
It's not really a health dish. Anyway, we've got a turnip over there, or a swede, as our folk south of the border would call it.
Yep.
And that's going to get boiled. And we've got the haggis. I'm not allowed to mention McSweeney's, so I wouldn't mention McSweeney's.
Oh, funny that. Other brands of haggis are available.
But it's one of those. And that's going in the oven.
OK.
And we'll serve it up with the clapshot and a whiskey gravy.
Right, so how do we get started?
What can we do to help?
Well, we'll peel the potatoes and the turnip. Oh, I've done that already.
Oh, thank goodness for that.
So we'll get some water on to boil.
Mm-hmm.
And... Mm-hmm. We'll get some water on to boil and get them on the go.
OK, great
stuff. Great STV kitchens here.
Yep. Spared no expense, obviously.
Absolutely.
There we go.
That's it.
That's the
OK, and we boiled some in this kettle earlier.
Now, Jennifer in the kitchen is the expert on the hob. Did she give you the hob lesson before she went on holiday?
I've not had any lesson. I've just been chucked in the kitchen.
Oh, no, there's a hob cut option. And it's Jennifer's across it. This is her turf.
Okay. Can I just say as well,
mm-hmm.
this is not mumps, I have these mumps of cakes all the time.
Well, that was from Talking Point earlier on the show. So, okay, let's plow on.
Okay, so...
We've got about 2 minutes.
Right, we've got about 2 minutes. Well, it'll take a bit longer for these to boil.
Okay.
But we've got water on for potatoes, water on for turnip. We'll get a wee bit of salt in them.
And a big bit,
of salt.
Well, you know, you don't really want to under-season them, that's for sure.
A bit of flavour, yeah.
We'll get that there. So... Because I'm so organised, that's all done already.
Great.
So we'll just pull these over. In fact, we'll just drain them.
Drain them,
probably
yeah.
A good idea.
Abusive.
Hands, they're clean. They're clean.
That's fine. Now, obviously haggis and its potatoes are really popular this time of year, but is this on your restaurant menu throughout the year?
It's on our menu all the time.
All year round?
All year round, and it's very popular.
I bet.
And it's very popular with Glaswegians as well as with tourists.
Mm.
It's a great dish. Even in the summer. In our cafe today, we actually had haggis broth on.
I've never thought
of
haggis.
No,
I know. Okay.
It was a bowl full of soup, I can tell you.
I bet
and it was.
Was
very popular. So, what can I say about haggis other than it's smashing?
Yep.
If you would pass me the turnip, then let's go into that.
Yep, see what you did.
Okay.
How many are we feeding here, Guy? That's lots of...
See, he's been here before, he knows Joan, camera one, likes his scran, so he's planned ahead.
I'll be competing against Joe, because I am starving tonight.
You got good
I'm ready for this. Oh, great.
Nice one.
The turnip and the potatoes we've kind of diced, because they'll cook quicker. Mm.
So how long, roughly, Guy, does it take to kind of put all this together if people were doing it at home?
Well, that haggis takes about an hour, just over an hour and a half to cook in the oven. Fortunately, here's one I did earlier.
Good.
We'll get that
we'll
in time for the show.
Down,
yeah.
I know.
Good.
But
so that's all getting in there. That's going to start.
And these.
That's fine.
By the time we're at the next sequence, mm-hmm. these will all be ready.
Great.
So I don't know. By the time the water comes to the boil, probably about 15, 20 minutes.
And you're serving it with a whiskey gravy.
And a whiskey gravy. Very simple. Whiskey just poured over it.
How much whiskey? Jerry wants to know.
How much whiskey are you driving in the morning?
I'm not driving, actually. No.
Well, there we are.
Great stuff.
There we are. And that's whiskey made in Glasgow.
Great stuff. Fantastic. We'll come back and see you in about half an hour, and then we'll get
looking
tucked in.
Looking forward to it.
Thanks very much. Well, we're having our Burns night supper here, obviously, as you can see in the studio, but it seemed very unfair to deny Colin the chance to have some haggis as well. Colin, you're at a very special Burns celebration tonight.
Indeed I am, Amy. I'm at officially the world's largest Burns supper, and here to enjoy the occasion is Libby McCarthy. Now, you're an actress and you have been on the TV for, I don't know, a while, but you look fantastic.
Not for a while, Colin.
That's true. Describe what you're wearing. You look amazing.
I'm dressed as a thistle. This is my best thistle impersonation. You know, well, tonight, Colin, my job is to do the reply. So, you know, I'm here as a comedian. Here to make them laugh and hopefully make them think a wee bit as well. But it's brilliant. I mean, it's the Lord Provost's Burns Supper. I'm so chuffed to be asked to, you know, do this. It's brilliant in there. I mean, it's a beautiful room, stout to the gunnels, and they're going to raise loads of money. So
And you've got some competition. We had the address of the haggis by a 16-year-old. It was incredible.
She was brilliant. Fellow ginger too. Absolutely gorgeous. Fantastic. Lucille Ball, eat your heart out. Oh. So, you know, good. She set me up going, right, if she's 16, she can do it. I'm an old woman. I've done it before, I'll be fine.
You're only 21, no?
Yes, again.
And the atmosphere in there, what's it like?
It's great. Do you know, Lord Provost, said a lot about, you know, people make Glasgow, and it's so true about the Glaswegian. There's just, everybody's so cheery. The table I'm at, I don't know anyone, and now we're all just laughing across the table. It's brilliant.
Fantastic. It's
brilliant. Burns would approve.
What are you going to say in your reply? Have you got it all in your head?
Yeah, well, I'm going to slag men off, of course. But in the end, I say, oh, bold, brave, muckle lords, I love you dearly and all that stuff. And it's a wee bit kind of philosophical. It's a wee bit kind of, you know, gender politics, as is my wont. The only thing is, Colin, it's at 11 o'clock at night. So they'll all be, hopefully they won't all be completely blittered and I'll get through.
I'm sure you'll be absolutely fine. Libby, thank you so much for joining
us.
You can go back and enjoy your food now.
Thank you, Colin.
But meanwhile, they've got haggis here. You've got haggis back in the studio. And earlier today, I had my own chance to enjoy some of Burns' finest. Take a look. So we all know the traditional Burns night food of haggis, neeps and tatties, but why not try something different this year? So I've come to 29 and the grill room at the square to find out how they do it.
My name's Grant Sherry. I work at the grill room, Royal Exchange Square. I have done for about nearly 9 years. I'm the sous chef here. My passion for food. I really love to cook in the house and things like that. So I've always wanted to do it since I've been a young boy. I'm doing beef Wellington with haggis, with clapshot potatoes, with a whiskey cavoli. It's a wee twist. So classically, a beef Wellington served with a mushroom duxelle mix. But we have put a wee twist and put the haggis into it rather than the mushroom duxelle. Also adds flavour and it's kind of on the buns. And clapshot is mashed potatoes with bash neeps mixed. And that's a classic dish for Orkney. It's usually served with oatcakes, but we'll serve it with a beef Wellington today. Yeah, well, you can get your cream potatoes from any supermarket. You can get your mashed turnip from almost any supermarket as well. Just mix the two of them together, season them up, and that's you get clapshot.
Okay, so we're here in the kitchen now with Grant, who's going to take us through how to make the beef Wellington with haggis. Where do we start?
Right, first of all, we have a whole fillet steak here, well, a whole piece of fillet, which is about 800 grams.
Make a good double team.
Yes, you sure would, mate. You sure would.
Well, so, Grant, what have you made of my cooking skills? Do you think I can join the restaurant?
Yes, yeah, it'd be a great team. It'd be a great team, mate. So, we would. Thanks very much for your help.
Right, absolutely. I'm going to go taste this now. So, let's see how it is. So, there we have it. Beef Wellington with haggis, here we go. That's fantastic.
Well, seeing as it's my first time presenting the show, I wanted to get round the whole Riverside Show studio, so I've joined Katie Palmer over here in social media to find out what everyone's
nice
been
saying. Nice to have you over here.
Great to be here. Yes. What's
like we're a colour explosion tonight.
I know.
Very colourful.
I know.
So yeah, actually we've had lots of people getting in touch wishing you good luck, Amy, and loving seeing you, so that's been really nice.
Oh, that's really
Jim's
nice.
Jim's tweeted in, good luck folks, and all change are playing musical chairs, so it's been great. Lisa had said Skerryvore should be on every Friday night. I have to agree.
They were great. They were absolutely fantastic,
really,
weren't they? A lot of people obviously getting in touch to say that they were really impressed with them.
Yeah, I've been really impressed with all the Celtic connections book that we've had on over the past little couple of weeks. So we've also been talking about, are people living the legacy of the Commonwealth Games? Are we getting fitter? The Arlington Baths has been in touch, said, too true, we've welcomed loads of new members since the Games.
Great to hear, yeah.
Yeah, really good. I've not been living the legacy so much myself, which is bad. Lee Wob Watson has said, the Games made me start the gym and football, but I've given up on the gym recently. I feel you're feeling your pain, Lee.
Not the only one, Lee.
And we've had lots of other people get in touch too. Jennifer said, the Games made me get back on my bike after a couple of years of it just sitting in my garage. Now I'm out on it regularly, feel much better, which is great. Good to hear. So if you've been getting involved in sports since the Games, let us know. You can tweet us at STV Glasgow and use the hashtag Riverside Show, and you can email us theriversideshow@stv.tv or post on our Facebook page.
Fantastic. And remember to also download the STV Glasgow app. Back to you, Jenny.
Great stuff, guys. Many thanks for that. Do get in touch because we love to hear from you. Now, we're going to take a short break, but stay with us to find out how Storm got on when she went down to the St. Enoch Centre to test your knowledge of Robbie Burns and from Glasgow University. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back here on The Riverside Show in 3 minutes.
The Riverside Show, sponsored by Fix from C.R. Smith.
Did you know Katie's Bar is Glasgow's best-kept secret? Did you know we have two separate bars, a games area and live entertainment 7 days a week? Not to mention well-known acts like me performing throughout the year. Well, it isn't a secret anymore. There's a warm and colourful welcome for all at Katie's Bar, John Street in the Merchant City, Glasgow, and also in Stirling.
What did I gain with age?
Confidence. Strength.
Friends that matter.
The look that defines me.
You gain so much with age. Why should your hair lose? Regardless of how old you are, your hair matures from root to tip. Dove Youthful Vitality helps replenish the nutrients hair loses, leaving hair soft, shiny, and looking fuller. Dove Youthful Vitality by Dove Advanced Hair Series.
When it comes to windows, doors, or conservatories, whoever fitted it, if it can be fixed, we will fix it. From handles to hinges, locks to leaks, no matter how old they are, with Fix from C.R. Smith, our team of trained technicians are fully equipped to put the value back into your home. No matter who installed them originally, we can fix any timber, UPVC or metal windows and doors. Get it fixed today. Call 0800 977 8800. Fix from C.R. Smith.
Experience a Canadian journey. Step aboard. Watch the world float by. Relax in style. Under our beautiful skies, enjoy unrivaled views, guaranteed to enthrall. Cruise, train, or car, in Canada, you can do it all. Enjoy relaxing, tailor-made holidays across Canada by train, coach, car, or cruise ship. You can do it all with CanadianAffair.com. 20th anniversary sale now on.
Here at McDonald Flooring, we aim to supply the best service, quality, and style. With premium brands including Antico, Antico Spacia, Moduleo and Condeen design floor coverings, plus a fully qualified installation team. Why not visit our showroom today for a free, no obligation quote? Love style, love quality, choose McDonald Flooring. 23 Sunderland Street, Annick Industrial Estate, Shettleston.
The Riverside Show, sponsored by Fix from C.R. Smith.
Welcome back to The Riverside Show. Now, as we all know by now, Sunday is Burns Night, and in just a moment, we'll be speaking to an expert on the Bard and his legacy.
But first, we wanted to know how well you know your Robbie Burns and whether you could tell Robbie from rubbish. So we sent Storm out to St. Enoch Centre today to put you all to the test.
Well, we all love Robbie Burns,
So we're here at the St Enoch Centre to see whether our fellow Glaswegians can tell the difference between rabby and rubbish. We have two parts of poems here. We've got one by McGonagall and one by our very own Rabbi Burns. So I'm about to speak to the people of St Enoch Centre to see if they can tell the difference between rabby and rubbish. So we've got two lines from two different poems, one by McGonagall, famously a rubbish poet, and the second by Rabbi Burns, and they go like this. For the stronger we are houses do build, the less chance we have of being killed. The second, our money lengthened sage advises, the husband's fray the wife's despises. Beautiful bit of Burns there. Let's go see if anyone knows the difference. Which one was rubbish and which one was rabby?
First one was rubbish.
Ding, 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 ding. Well done, guys, you got that right. The second one was our very own Rabbi Burns. The second one's rubbish. Second one's Burns.
There you go. Put that on his feet.
So what do you think's rubbish? What do you think's rabby?
The second one's rabby.
Ding, 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 ding. We've got some more winners.
I'll go for the second, being Burns.
Very well done. You might not be from Scotland, but you know your Rabbi Burns from rubbish. Do you know any poems yourself?
Oh, none that I could repeat on camera.
A man's a man for all that. For all that and for all that, a man's a man.
I'd say the first one was rabbi and the last one was rubbish.
Oh no! The second one was rabbi and the first one was rubbish.
I would suggest that the second one is rabbi Burns.
Very good, sir. Absolutely right.
Poor and timorous beastie. Oh, what a panic in my breastie.
Have you got any others?
It's about a wee miss.
Have you got any others?
No, I know he was a philanderer, put it that way. Stay away from the kind of men, no?
She's put her husband up for the challenge. Here we go. For the stronger we are houses do build, the less chance we have of being killed. What did you think about that? Is it any good?
Well, it's not bad, but I don't think it's rabbi.
The second one's rabbi and the first one's rubbish.
Oh, you are good. Are you a rabbi fan?
I grew up in Ayrshire, so the Mosses, water slaps and styles that lie between us and our hame, where sits our sulky, sullen dame, gearing her bruise like a gathering storm and nursing her wrath to keep it warm. Here's you, the first verse.
You lied when you said you knew the first few lines. Well, I think it's fair to say everybody knows who Rabbi Burns is. And most people could tell they're rabbi for the rubbish. So, well done, Glasgow. I'm going to give you an A for success today on knowing your rabbi for your rubbish.
See, loads of people in Glasgow know their Burns. That was great.
That was very good.
Do you know?
I do. Oh, there's that one. What's it about? A moose. A wee sleek it, coor and beastie. Oh, what a panic in thy breastie, or something like that.
You're just saying that because the guy in that video just said that. You're copying him.
Nah, I knew it already.
Aye, I'm sure you did.
Of course
I did.
You can't do any better.
My love is like a red, red rose which newly sprung in June. My heart is like a melody that sweetly plays its tune. I could go on. Do you want me to keep on going?
No, please don't. We're joined now by Dr. Pauline Mackay from Glasgow University. And as we've just seen in Storm's piece there, a lot of people in Glasgow are a little bit rusty when it comes to Burns, but still know some of his poetry.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, people are really familiar with Burns's poetry, not only because we're told about it and we learn about it in school, we read about it, but actually Burns is so popular. We see his poetry everywhere, people perform it for us. There's a lot of Burns in print culture, even objects and statuary. Mm. Yeah.
So what makes him so popular, Lo, and do you think his popularity has continued throughout the years?
I think his popularity has continued throughout the years, and not just here, but abroad, over in the US, all over the world, in fact. Burns has been translated into almost every language. And I think it's the fact that his work is so diverse, there's something there that everyone can enjoy or understand.
And we even know things like his silhouette exam, for example. You see that on cards and in wallpapers and stuff. He's kind of around us without realising he's there.
Absolutely. He's an icon. He's a recognisable universal literary icon.
I know he does. And is it the fact that he is kind of drummed into us at school, or do you think people just have this natural, oh, he's the national bard type thing, we want to kind of know more, or is it pushed a lot in schools?
Well, actually, I don't think Burns is taught as much in schools now as he used to be, and there could always be more. I think it is this, you know, he's the national bard, and every single year in January, there are these huge worldwide celebrations, and that does a lot to keep Burns in our cultural memory as well.
And obviously, as we know, it is well documented. Burns was a bit of a ladies' man, but he also really cared a lot of causes as well. He cared for people who were less fortunate than himself as well, didn't he?
Well, yeah, Burns is celebrated as a humanitarian, as a poet who was concerned with, for example, equality and fraternity and friendship. Yeah.
You mentioned there a bit about, you know, the celebrations, obviously, that'll be happening this weekend in Scotland. You know, does that take place across the world as well? Is anything celebrated across the globe, or is it mainly just here in Scotland that we'll see these big events?
No, across the globe. There are huge Burns suppers being held everywhere this weekend, in the US, in Russia, everywhere.
Well, we're having a Burns night in tonight as well. We're making our haggis, neeps and tatties for two for a tenner. Colin's live at the Thistle Hotel in the city centre, having a big Burn, the world's biggest Burns supper, but he's also done loads of really good stuff in his time as well. He bought a ticket to Jamaica because he was concerned about slavery as well. Can you tell us a bit about that?
Okay, well, Burns bought a ticket to Jamaica to go and you know, to seek to go and be employed in a slave plantation, so there's a little bit of controversy there.
Wow, okay.
But he actually didn't go, and the reason he didn't go is because shortly before he was due to leave, he published his first edition of poetry, poems chiefly in the Scottish dialect, and it was very successful. So he stayed here in Scotland to capitalise on that and to make a name for himself as a poet.
Brilliant, absolutely. And obviously you're an expert from Glasgow University. Is there one piece of knowledge that maybe the general public and ourselves don't actually know about? And what do you think's the most fascinating thing that you've found in your research?
There are lots of poems of Burns that we're not entirely familiar with because maybe they've been controversial over the years and therefore they were suppressed, but they're widely available to us now. And also he wrote and collected almost twice as many songs as poems he wrote, so Burns is actually one of possibly the world's greatest songwriters.
So, putting you on the spot here, what's your favourite Burns piece of poetry?
Oh, I have to say, for the performativity and the, just the sheer joy of it, that I love Tam O'Shanter. And I know that sounds like an obvious answer, but I love it.
And obviously you'll be having haggis this weekend?
Certainly, I will be having haggis this weekend and I will be joining celebrations with people all over the world on the About Scotland website.
Brilliant. Thanks very much for joining us, Dr. Pauline. Hope to see you again.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Cheers.
Now, here in Glasgow, we're blessed with some amazing parks and gardens, and one of the jewels in the city's crown are the Botanic Gardens and the Kibble Palace in the West End.
But if you head up to the Botanics between now and February the 15th, you'll get the chance to see them like never before, thanks to the festival Electric Gardens. The Riverside Show went along last night for a preview. Take a look.
The West End Festival has been going for 19 years and I'd been wanting to do stuff in the winter for quite a long time. People have suggested, for example, fireworks displays and things like that, which in June are pretty silly because you have to wait till about 11 o'clock at night. So I began to think about doing things in the winter, and when the idea about doing a light show, a Sony Lumiere type show, came into my mind, I began to speak to the Glasgow City Council, and this is what it is.
I'm Liz Scobie, I'm chairman of the West End Festival. Right now we're standing in the magnificent setting of the Botanic Gardens here in Glasgow for what is the very first electric gardens. We have illuminated the Botanic Gardens and people can walk around and see something quite unique. It has never looked like this before. In winter, generally, the park is closed at dusk, so people don't wander around the park in the dark. This is a very unique experience.
I've lived in this area for about 25 years and it's just showing the gardens in a completely different light, literally. It's really, really beautiful. It's really atmospheric.
We've used characteristics of the Botanic Gardens. Obviously, there's fantastic mature trees, which are being lit in different ways. There's the railway tunnels, which have got a special effect, as if there's a train going through them.
There's a magnificent Kibble Palace here, this Victorian masterpiece, which is all lit up inside, and there's all sorts of exciting sounds, which are particularly thrilling, I think, for the children. And of course, as you walk round the park, there's all sorts of fun surprises.
There's a couple of very hidden away parts of the Botanic Gardens where you go in and it's a whole little magical world which you'd never normally see. And several people have already said to me this evening that they never realised that certain elements were here. They take it for granted. But at night, you know, literally a light is shone in these corners and people notice it.
We've got a superb creative team who've been working on this for months, and there's all sorts of performers. There are fire jugglers and saxophonists and illuminated saxophonists, I should say. So yeah, there's been a tremendous team effort been going on for months.
It's a matter of, I think, doing things outdoors, obviously, and so we're looking at different things that involve maybe fire and light and things to do in the winter. I mean, the beauty about doing it in the winter is you can do it at, say, 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock when families can attend. And it's very important that the Western Festival is a very broad-based church, and from that point of view, if you're doing these things in the early evening, you know, the families can come, and it's very important to Glasgow to satisfy that part of the population. And also, I mean, I'm very pleased to say that people have been booking up from far and wide. What we're trying to sell here is atmosphere right in the centre of the city.
Coming up after the break, we're back in the kitchen trying our haggis, neeps and tatties, tea for a tenner. I personally can't wait. We'll see you after the break.
The Riverside Show, sponsored by Fix from C.R. Smith.
Teaser rate credit cards. It's you versus your bank. Either you remember when they told you the introductory rate would end, or you forget. You get caught out when the interest rate rockets up and end up paying a whole lot more. You both want to win, but only one of you can. Is this really the sort of relationship you want? It's why at Royal Bank of Scotland we've said goodbye to teaser rate credit cards and hello to credit cards that won't try to catch you out. Goodbye, unfair banking. Hello, Royal Bank of Scotland.
Do adrenaline, do adventure, do nature. You can do it all with CanadianAffair.com. 20th anniversary sale now on.
For the first time ever, Persil has combined a new boosted liquid with built-in stain removers. Persil Dual Action Capsules penetrate and attack stains, giving you an unbeatable clean. Try new Persil Dual Action Capsules in your wash today. Always keep away from children.
What did I gain with age?
Confidence.
Strength.
Friends that matter.
The look that defines me.
You gain so much with age. Why should your hair lose? Regardless of how old you are, your hair matures from root to tip. Dove Youthful Vitality helps replenish the nutrients hair loses, leaving hair soft, shiny, and looking fuller. Dove Youthful Vitality by Dove Advanced Hair Series.
Become a recruitment genius and recruit the best staff available for just £199 with recruitmentgenius.com.
People always say eventually, if only, one day. But with Kitchens International, make that day today with up to 25% off bespoke kitchens and up to 70% off X display in our January sale. Kitchens International. Stop dreaming. Start designing.
I know what you're thinking. He looks like a bit of a geek. But when you've invented the cure for comparison blindness, you can look as geeky as you want. Using independent data from DeFacto, Go Compare lets you easily see the difference between home or car policies. Go Compare that.
The Riverside Show, sponsored by Fix from C.R. Smith.
Welcome back to the Riverside Show, where we're back in the kitchen with Guy Cowan from Guy's Restaurant, who's making us haggis, neeps and tatties for our Burns Night tea for a tenner. And it's looking good, and I'm pretty excited about this. Guy, where have we got to?
We're all ready to go.
Yes.
Sounds good. Let's get it.
Because your tummy was rumbling. I could hear that on the sofa.
I know. It's been a while since lunch. Give me a break.
So, shall we go?
Yes, let's
do it.
Guy.
Right. So, everything's ready.
and everything's a bit worn. And we have a spoon, and we're going to use this one, shall we?
Yeah, why not?
Okay, get rid of that.
We'll move up slightly.
So, here's the wonderful moist, reeking.
Looking good. Make sure you give me a bigger portion than Jenny.
No, this is we're all sharing.
Oh, we're all sharing it.
We're doing one... sharesies. Sharesies. Oh, we're all pals here.
It's comrade haggis tonight.
Now, can I ask something? Did you buy this haggis?
That's a bought haggis.
That's
yes.
Haggis. Do you make it from scratch in the restaurant, or is it something you buy in from the trades?
You buy in such good haggis. Mm-hmm. There's people make such good haggis that I'm a kind of bit of a believer that why the hell would you spend time doing something when some people do it just as well as you'll ever do it yourself.
Absolutely.
So.
Now, this, you can't get any more Scottish than haggis, noops and tatties. On your restaurant, do you have a lot of Scottish dishes?
We have quite a lot of Scottish. We use a lot of Scottish produce.
Produce, that's the good stuff, isn't it?
We use a lot of beef, venison, a lot of fish, lamb. So, but we don't necessarily always cook them in a Scottish fashion.
But now we've got a Glaswegian whiskey.
And we've got a Glaswegian whiskey gravy.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
There we are.
Okay, wow.
So.
We done?
We are. The only thing, maybe a wee bit of black pepper on it.
Great. Oh, yeah. Love that.
Okay.
That's looking nice.
And Amy, lady
first. Oh, I get
first.
To do the honours?
Yeah, you go first, you go first.
Need, you wouldn't need a knife.
Right, so just...
She's right in there, look at that,
I know,
with the fork.
No holding back, Jerry, no holding back. Right. Is it going to be too hot? I'm going to burn my mouth, I'm all right.
And why would you apply just the whiskey just over it? Is that a guy's secret or is that a traditional Scottish
thing? Well, that was actually
really
from
good.
Burn suppers I used to go to years ago. Mm-hmm. It was always the traditional thing. The whiskey gravy was just whiskey poured over it. I just have kept that up. I like that.
Oh, it's fab.
Now, you said earlier that you'd eat haggis all year round, but I always think of it as a nice, hearty comfort winter dish. Do a lot of people eat this in the restaurant throughout the year?
Oh, yeah. We'd sell a lot of it in summer.
What's the restaurant like for you in terms of January? Obviously, being people after Christmas, is it pretty busy?
It's busy. It's not as busy, obviously, as December. People still want to eat out. They're maybe being a bit more cost-conscious. We, incidentally, have got a great burnt supper on Monday night in the restaurant. There's a couple of spaces available still.
So it's not quite a sellout yet?
Well, it will be, but... And we've got quite a lot of Scottish talent, really good Scottish talent, like Ian Robertson, Dave Anderson, Stephen Duffy, and various people all performing.
Sounds like a fun night. So, sounds good. Absolutely. So you'll be serving this up?
That's the starter.
That's the starter.
That's the starter. There's a four-course meal.
Wow. Well, if the viewers at home want to know how to make Guy's lovely haggis, neeps and tatties here, the recipe's on your screen right now. But don't worry if you don't have a pen and paper, we're also going to put it on the STV Glasgow Twitter feed, so you'll find it there.
It will. Check out our social media for Guy's top tips on this nice wee dish. Now, you're on the Riverside, you've been here a few times now, but you've also got an advert on the channel as well, so you're getting around on STV Glasgow, matey.
I won a competition.
I'm having more than that.
Oh, she's away into it.
I won a competition back in October or something on STV, and they came and shot an ad in the restaurant and gave me screenings in the month of November.
Brilliant.
Which was fantastic, absolutely.
So what did you have to do to win that? Because our lot here, they're tight when it comes to the air time. What's going on?
I had to bribe someone.
Did you? Yeah. I knew you've got a look about you.
Don't be telling us that.
No, I just had to register. And obviously I've got a nice touch on the button, so...
Great stuff. Well, Guy, thanks very much for coming in.
You're
again.
Very
this is absolutely delicious. Check this out.
Lovely. I'll finish this off while you...
She's right in there, my goodness. She's never eaten before in her life. Now, when Amy tucks into this and enjoys our burn supper, Colin, as always, has to take it one step further. So he's taking part in the largest Burns Night meal in the world. Colin, our haggis is pretty decent. How's yours?
It's absolutely fantastic, and joining me now is the Lord Provost of Glasgow. Now, it's a fantastic evening here. Are we on for a world record?
We're on for two records tonight. We're hoping to achieve the £1 million that we've raised for charities since the Lord Provost Burn Supper began. And also, we are going for the Guinness Book of Records to make sure that this is recognised as the largest burn supper in the world. So the adjudicators can round at present moment, counting everyone in.
And how many people do you think are here in the festival?
There'll be over 700 tonight.
That's a lot of haggis.
It's a lot of haggis, and I've been speaking to a number of people and they've all enjoyed the haggis.
I'm kind of keeping you from yours at the moment, but what's the atmosphere like here?
I think the atmosphere is absolutely fantastic, but it normally is. It's a great night. It's a great night in the calendar of Glasgow when, as I said, over 700 people come together, and it is for the purpose of goodwill for the Glasgow citizens, and tonight the other charity is the Bow Bath charity.
You're raising a whole lot of money. What kind of companies are in the room tonight?
There's many companies in the room tonight. There's some individuals that come along every year as well. So there's a number of companies here tonight. We have an auction and we have a raffle prize. We have a beautiful auction prize tonight, and it was one of our own staff that has painted the City Chambers, which is an absolute stunning. I don't know whether you've seen it, but it's an absolute stunning photograph, so or a painting. So I'm looking forward to seeing how much that will go tonight in the auction.
I've got to ask about, you know, the opening speech to the address to the haggis. What did you think of it?
I thought the young lady was absolutely fantastic. I don't think I could have done anything like that at 16. I can hardly do it at the age that I'm at. But it just goes to show the talent that's in the city. She goes to the Knightswood School of Art, and she certainly proved tonight that she's fantastic, and she's certainly one to watch in the future.
I'm looking forward to the year ahead. It's only January, but does Glasgow have a bright 2015?
There's a number of big things coming. There's the Turner Prize coming, so we're hoping again that a Glasgow alumni will win that. Just now we have Celtic Connections, we have sports, lots of sports coming. We have the Davis Cup coming, Great Britain versus the USA. So we're doing very, very well.
Brilliant. That's the Lord Provost of Glasgow here at what could be and should be the largest burn supper in the world. It's back to you.
But is he wearing a kilt?
We still don't know that, do we? I'd like to know, Colin, please. Well, lots of us will be celebrating Burns Night either at home or out and about this weekend. But if you're looking for some other ideas of what you can get up to, then there's only one person who's got all the info. Here's our Rachel.
Hello, it's finally time for your weekend What's On, where we've picked some great going out ideas for those of you who are out and about in town. But we still have some good TV if some of you are staying in. First up, this is a very special event close to all of us here on the Riverside Show. One, because we absolutely love electronic Celtic fusion bands from the Isle of Skye, obviously. And two, because our technical operator, Innes, happens to be a musician in this particular electronic Celtic fusion band from the Isle of Skye. Yes, Nightworks are at the Oranmore, and it's tonight. And next up, This Is Not a Burns Night is on this weekend, a fundraiser for Govan Hill Baths Community Trust, including music, drama, poetry and rap with Becky Wallace, Loki, Lenka Montenegro, Kat Hepburn and the Govan Hill Theatre Group. It's hosted by Jim Monaghan and you only pay what you think it's worth, so be generous about it. That's at the Govan Hill Baths from 7:30 tonight. And the Electric Gardens light up the botanics in a way you've never seen them before this week, giving a beautiful visual display that'll give the Christmas season a twinkly run for its money. Even if you're not a West Ender, it's worth a trip to the botanics this weekend with your kiddies to see the place illuminate. And there's a wonderful event at McSorley's with our pals, the Daddy Naggins, headlined by Daniel Mead and the Flying Mules. It's free entry, runs from 8 p.m. on Sunday night, and with a lineup like that, you'd be a fool not to at least drop in for a dram or a fruit cordial before hitting the town. And if none of that floats your boat, here's what's on the TV tonight. Coming up on STV Glasgow, we've got the STV Glasgow News at 8:30, followed by Days of Honour at 9, and it's Peter and Ruffy's football show at 10:30, followed by More Love from Us in a repeat of the Riverside show at 11:30. All that still to come on STV Glasgow.
Well, as Rachel mentioned, Friday night here on STV Glasgow means it's Days of Honour. It's on tonight at 9 p.m. If you don't know about it, it's time to get involved. Here's a taster.
STV Glasgow is giving you another chance to see the first two series of the award-winning Polish wartime drama, Days of Honour. Trained to fight behind enemy lines and parachuted back into occupied Poland. A band of fearless men living through their country's darkest hour, inspired only by a belief humanity will prevail. watching and waiting to strike back. An addictive series, a compelling story of ordinary people living through extraordinary times. Through days of violence, days of passion, days of honour. Tonight at 9 on STV Glasgow.
It's a great show. That's episode 2 of series 1. Have you seen it yet?
No, I've not. I've been meaning to check it out. The first episode's on STV.
At 9 p.m. But remember, if politics is your thing and you want to catch up on the goings-on in the world of Scottish politics, then STV Glasgow is where you need to be. Here with what's coming up this weekend, check out this devilishly handsome presenter, Amy. Join us on Scottish Parliament this week for featured debates from the past week at Holyrood. On the show this weekend, Finance Secretary John Swinney calls on MSPs to agree to the general principles he outlined for the next Scottish budget, and we've got the weekly First Minister's questions. Tune in to Scottish Parliament this week, 1 p.m. this Saturday and Sunday afternoon on STV Glasgow in the west and STV Edinburgh in the east.
Where we're going to take a last quick break, but stay with us because we've got more live music from Skerryvore after the break.
The Riverside Show, sponsored by Fix from C.R. Smith.
Did you know Katie's Bar is Glasgow's best-kept secret? Did you know we have two separate bars, a games area and live entertainment 7 days a week? Not to mention well-known acts like me performing throughout the year. Well, it isn't a secret anymore. There's a warm and colourful welcome for all at Katie's Bar, John Street in the Merchant City, Glasgow, and also in Stirling.
When it comes to windows, doors or conservatories, whoever fitted it, if it can be fixed, we will fix it. From handles to hinges, locks to leaks, no matter how old they are, with Fix from C.R. Smith, our team of trained technicians are fully equipped to put the value back into your home. No matter who installed them originally, we can fix any timber, UPVC or metal windows and doors. Get it fixed today. Call 0800 977 8800. Fix from C.R. Smith.
Do rail journeys, do road trips, do cruising. You can do it all with CanadianAffair.com. 20th anniversary sale now on.
Since the dawn of time, all those millennia ago, it's often felt like you had to be part of an elite group to obtain a credit card. Well, at Luma, we've tried to create a card that's a bit more friendly. If you got poor credit, you could be accepted. With no annual fee and credit limits up to £1,500, Luma has been designed with the kind of perks you'd expect from some of the more exclusive credit cards. So, with a response in 60 seconds, go to luma.co.uk today.
Here at McDonald Flooring, we aim to supply the best service, quality and style. With premium brands including Antico, Antico Spacia, Moduleo and Condeen Design floor coverings, plus a fully qualified installation team. Why not visit our showroom today for a free, no obligation quote? Love style, love quality, choose McDonald Flooring. 23 Sunderland Street, Annick Industrial Estate, Shettleston.
I know what you're thinking. He looks like a bit of a geek. But when you've invented the cure for comparison blindness, you can look as geeky as you want. Using independent data from DeFacto, Go Compare lets you easily see the difference between home or car policies. Go Compare that.
The Riverside Show, sponsored by Fix from C.R. Smith.
Welcome back to the Riverside Show. Now, we love hearing from you live here in the studio, and our very own queen of social media, Katie Palmer, being across what you're saying online. What are people getting in touch with tonight,
well,
Katie?
Well, you're still getting in touch telling us how the games affected you, and
Anissa had said, it's definitely inspired me to get more fit and healthy and encouraged me to stop being so lazy and go to the gym and get back into running.
Good for
which
her.
Which is great, I know. Particularly considering all the food we've been eating recently. Karen, PT said, in the mood for some haggis thanks to Gary's restaurant.
It was delicious, Karen. It was really yummy.
Yeah, definitely. I'm really excited about it. And I need to try some after the show. Looking forward to it. Mish has been in touch.
Our pal
Mish, yes. And she sounds like she's having a great time at home. And Aussie styling of tuna haggis. Mish is Australian.
She is.
And played the pipes for my London visitors. So, there's another tweet, but extra details.
You probably
know it's Greek because the Mediterranean veggies were cooked by Abby. And it's Aussie, as she put it on oatcakes, and it looks pretty delicious.
She's just showing off again, isn't she? That looks great,
though.
She's
just teasing us here in the
studio
as well.
I know, with her pals up from London. Lucky her.
Absolutely, it's brilliant. And Club Noir have been in touch because the Fire Thrower from tonight's Electric Gardens are featured at their next club night on Valentine's Day. So if you want to see more of him after Electric Gardens, Forbidden Fruit on Valentine's Day is the place to go.
Is that your way of asking me to go to Club Noir on Valentine's Day with you?
Cheeky date.
That'd
be fun. And we've also got some sad news tonight. Missing woman Anne Rooney from East Kilbride.
Okay.
So if anybody has spotted Anne anywhere, then please get in touch with the police and let them know.
Okay, and if they do, how can they also get in touch with us here on the Riverside Show?
You can tweet at STV Glasgow using the hashtag Riverside Show, or you can post on our Facebook page, STV Glasgow, or email the Riverside Show at stv.tv.
Great stuff. Loads of ways to get in touch, and hopefully Anne will be found safe and well.
Absolutely.
Now, we love our live music here on the Riverside Show, and our band tonight are simply sensational with Can You Hear Us? And I think you might, because they're pretty loud. It's Skerryvore. Woo!
From all the lies that have been thrown, show the world your face, you're not alone. 'Cause I wanna know, you listen to us now, can you hear us, can you hear us shout? 'Cause I wanna know, that you really understand, that you truly got it figured out. 'Cause I wanna know, you listen to us now. Spark the flame, take the jump, bridge the gap, no regrets, no looking back. 'Cause I wanna know, will you listen to us now? Can you hear us? Can you hear us shout? 'Cause I wanna know that you really understand, that you truly got it figured out. 'Cause I
you guys. That was brilliant.
Thanks a lot, guys. Good to see you all. Nice one.
Very good. So, you guys are from Tirisdeach. What's it like coming to Glasgow? You've been successful all over the place, but what's the, you know, the music scene like here?
It's great. Yeah, it's actually just the two Gillespie brothers in the band here. They're from Tirisdeach, so.
Oh, you can tell you're related. You can tell you're related.
Yeah, we've been in Glasgow for a good while now. That's where we base ourselves. It's a great hub for kind of live music, especially. Right now with Celtic Connections being on as well. It's fantastic.
And on that note, we've been celebrating Celtic Connections across the Riverside show. Yeah. Have you got a gig coming up?
We have, yeah. Ours is in the fruit market on the 30th, so we're very excited to be doing that again.
That sounds really good. Big anniversary year for you guys, 2015. What's your plan to kind of celebrate this year?
We have a lot of big plans that we're not allowed to say too much about until we've done our Celtic Connections gig, but we can.
Oh, come on!
We can tell everyone that it's on the 30th of May this year, so save that date and please come along once we release all the further details of it.
Yeah. Oh, so we'll have to wait to find
out. We've got a few fans in the STV Glasgow building, so I think that was good news for some people watching. Great stuff. So what song are you going to perform for us next?
Well, next one's going to be Walk With Me.
And apart from the gig at Celtic Connections, is there anything else coming up that we should know about here in Glasgow?
You can always check our website at skerryvore.com, which always has the kind of has more knowledge about what we're doing than I do. So check that rather than asking me. So.
And you guys are from Tirisdeach, and I believe there's a bit of a music festival happening in July. Is that right?
That's right. Yeah, it's Daniel here on the accordion. He actually runs the music festival in Tirisdeach, which we play it every year. Highly recommend going to it. It's a great festival. If we do say so ourselves, you know, we're a bit biased. But
well, you can have to, as you
he's right there, you know. You've got to kind of say it's all right, so.
Exactly. And just name that. What's the last song you're playing for us tonight? What's it called?
It's Walk With Me.
Walk With Me. Great stuff. Fantastic stuff. Guys, thank you very much indeed for that.
And that's all we've got time for tonight.
Thank you very much for presenting, Amy. It was your first live show. Hope you enjoyed it. Would you come back?
Oh, of course I would, but will you have me, though?
I might put a good word in with the boss, I suppose so.
Please do. Jennifer and David are back on Monday and they'll meet a man who has tested over 80 pies from football grounds around the country and then graded them.
That's a really tough gig.
That sounds like a good job. I think I'd quite...
We could have done that.
I think I'd quite like to do that.
I think you could do all right with that yeah.
But for now, to close the show, we hand you back to the fantastic, entertaining Skerryvore. Have a great weekend.
Thanks, guys. Have a good weekend.
You.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Life would be a duller game if each one of us were all the same.